Does he know he's streaming? Fuck yeah, he knows he's streaming. Set this up for the last 26 million hours. Of course I know I'm streaming.
Get your sets out in the chat, boys. Oh, Reba.
So we're gonna be opening 7-5 suited because we're on a table of bitches.
Yes, yes, we've got him, boys. We've got him now.
Damn, he's played back against our 7-5 suited. Guys, type shh in the chat.
Here comes the 10 in our streets.
Boys, just join me in prayer and say, our Lord and Father, Corona, please allow us to all stay inside for just a little bit longer to keep all these punty people on our stakes whilst we move up through the bankroll challenge. Amen. And off we go. Solid. Gonna be 3-betting the 9-8 suited here against what's understandably a recreational player. Gonna be 3-betting the patriarchy just to maintain our tyrannical reign as men on this planet. Gonna be C-betting real big. It's a funny thing, moving up stakes. I feel it now, genuinely, like, expecting the players to be really good at poker, which is hilarious, because, I mean, no offense to the 10-0 regs out there, they're generally not the best at poker. You know, they're not the worst, you know, if you get to 10-0, congratulations, not taking that away from you. But comparison to people that play high stakes, I mean, it's not really a comparison. But I still have that thing of, like, oh my god, what if? What if they're just gonna, like, crush me, you know? What if they're just gonna own me? Like this guy. What if he's just got ace king? Jack 10. It's strange because I can play the highest stakes that exists out there with, you know, a large percentage of my own roll, or even if I'm being staked, you know, it's still a large amount to win or lose. Where I know that I'm playing not just for myself, but for the things that I care about most in the world, like my charity. But still there's something about poker which allows, and the way that my mind interacts with poker, that allows me to just switch the hell off. I don't know if we should check or bet. I'm gonna check. Whoa. Holy crap, boys. Anyone see that? Mental. Guys, get your sets out in the chat. So good at sets. It went open 25 cents, 3-bet to 75 cents. Cool. Going to be check calling. Going to be raising. God, how beautiful is this spot? As long as this guy doesn't squeeze, how beautiful is that? Shout out to Ace Queen. Shout out to Ace Queen. Ace Queen. Ace Queen. Also going to be 3-betting this one. 3-1. And we are not going to be folding here, boys. If he has trapped us, he's trapped us. If not, I'll take it. Club. Club hot. Hot, hot, hot. Club, club, club. Good game. Love the stream. Sorry for calling for your death. Shout out to Jimmy 410. It's a nice flop. Especially against someone with a loose 3-bet range. If he does have one. We don't know if he does. Very small sample, obviously. But there's a higher chance than normal that he has a loose 3-bet range. Half pot, man. Interesting. Forgotten Boys. 3-bet and C-bet against this guy from Hungary. Which is kind of like a mini Russia, so I've got to be careful. Just check it. And then bet the river. If he has king, queen, king, ten, he's going to call us. If he has anything less, I imagine he's out of there. Pimp for 7-7, would you be down to play East Ham's heads up now? Yeah, so East Ham's has been talking shit about my family. So I'm definitely willing to own him in the streets. He actually said that that he wants to murder and murder my grandpa and take all the money from my grandma when she dies as well. Yeah, he got really specific talking about like how he's gonna write himself into the will, he's gonna like marry my grandma, all of this kind of stuff. It was pretty brutal, to be honest. So I felt like the only reasonable response was to play him heads up for rolls. So if we can get the hashtag fuck Easterdams out in the chat, that'd be great. Gonna be check shoving here. Win everything, boys. No, I was kidding, I don't feel too bad anymore. It's over. Gonna be 3-betting the flop, not because we're tilted, but because this guy knows who we are, so he probably also knows that this is a good spot to check raise a lot. We can have aces, we can have ace x of hearts, block some hands that we're shoving. He's probably full of shit. Shoving, not full of shit at all. There's something about this type of music, man. It really gets my soul singing. And it's the fact that as well, you can start harmonizing so easily and you can start just like chanting along. And I'd say it's quite meditative. Say that 3 times fast. Meditative. Gonna be calling twice then. Question is, do we bet or check? I think we gotta go for a bet. Definitely not always ahead here, but I think there's just a few too many things to try and get value from, and we do have bluffs in orange. Gonna be betting C-bet small here, and probably double barreling a lot. What did my mum say about not bluffing Russians? I think the same stands for Ukrainians. Alright, we're gonna be check calling the river. Against most sizes. Fish shoves, we're probably out of there. Thing about ace rivers is that people ain't calling much. Because everyone puts an ace in your range, so they're good to bluff. Yeah, if that wasn't clear sarcasm to absolutely everyone in the chat, if there are a couple of people, and I appreciate the sincere, nice words, the East Ham's thing is a complete joke, but please do help me spread the awareness that he has threatened to kill my cat multiple times, and the only real way to get going on that kind of threat is to challenge him to heads up for rolls. So I'm going to be playing him heads up on stream. Just one of those tables that you just feel like everyone's probably going to be playing like a little hoe. And this guy seems like he's probably going to fold to our gut shot. Also, shout out to the patriarchy. King 4 off and the patriarchy. What? Woohoo! Boys. Going to be going for a 4-bet with the patriarchy. Gonna be C-bet. Gonna be checking the turn. Shout out to Pocket Tens. 3-5 suited. Oh. And this is why you shouldn't be ranging people. I'd say we got the max there. Shout out to the dishwashers. Maybe he's a friend of the stream. That's really funny. Yeah, that's kind of like one of the biggest whoopas you can do to someone when you see their play. Just be like, he must be a friend of the stream. This song, if anyone hasn't heard me say this a million times before, makes me very happy because it makes me think of my cat waddling around the house. Makes me so happy. Gonna be check raising the dishwashers here. So calling this pretty full. Gonna be checking the turn. Gonna be calling the flop. Very tempted to shove. Extremely tempted to shove. We're actually gonna go for an overbet. Snap call. No good, sir, no good. Shout out to the dishwashers doing their job extremely well. Probably fair enough to give them that kind of label. It takes them a long time to get there. Like, good 70 years before they start catching on. And the American sarcasm is a lot like saying, like, oh yeah, this is true, and then saying, not. Alright, we're going to be calling one of the best turns we can get. Going to be calling a 3-bet here, and so good at sets, just to prove a point. Going to be betting here. Alright, I'm not going to lie, this does feel a bit like Queens. We're not folding in 300 million years, but it feels a bit like Queens. Dude, shout out to I Am R Word. Try and swear a bit less. Got him. Get your marvelouses out in the chat. So good at sets. So good at sets. Nine. Shout out to So Good at Boats. Does that count as a set, guys? Can we at least give me the thumbs up for running good with boats as well?
Why you came here. Remember your life is sacred. Remember why you came here. Remember your life is sacred.
Gonna be giving this guy a chance to bluff if he wants. Don't have queens, please, good sir. Gonna be going all in. Ace, king of spades, unfortunate. Unfortunate. Whoa, the dream boys. Ah, yeah. Imagine that one. Would have felt good.
Imagine there's no heaven.
Shout out to boats.
It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid.
Guys, it's such a good spot to hit a set.
As you stand dancing by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. For I can't help falling in love with you. I can't.
This is worrying.
Falling in love with you.
Sometimes when you sing, you got to imagine the person that you love. Damn. All right. The only reason I'm calling this is because he might be a recreational player with a random hand.
Cool.
I don't expect it, but I very much like it if you explain the thought process while playing. Maybe it's a challenge, not for educational purposes. It's definitely for educational purposes, but to go in loads of depth would require a lot of backstory, if that makes sense. So I can definitely speak about some of the hands that I'm doing in a bit of depth. But if you really wanted to explore my thought process in a way that was accurate enough to replicate, then you would need to know a lot about how to think about poker. And I've gone over that in my masterclass, so I imagine a lot of people watching this will have already watched the masterclass, so hopefully they'll understand a lot of what I say quite quickly. But for the people that haven't, they won't understand the structure in which I think about poker. It's very different to how other people teach thinking about poker. So I will be going into some detail here. Like here, we're going a size that I think ace highs and some other stuff might call. Because we have a hand that we're definitely going to be double barreling on the turn. Going to be calling. This is confusing. I don't actually know what to do, but we're going for a 4-bet. The problem is that we're so deep stacked with this guy and this guy's 3-bet under the gun. These are two reasons not to 4-bet. However, this guy being short means that we want to get it inverse him. So hopefully this guy is going to be having a 3-bet bluff range. Maybe he can have ace king. The problem is, if he shoves, we're kind of priced in, which is unfortunate. So if he does have aces or kings, GG us. If it's queens, well, that's a blessing. Again, check raise it. Pretty happy about it. Got it through. So we're in a very good spot. Getting in against ace, 8-5 suited, sorry. I'm used to saying ace when we're talking about stuff we're getting in against. Ace I board. Oh shit. 3. King, hold. Nice. We're going to boys. Going to be calling the turn here. Unfortunate river. Probably can't fold no matter what, although I will definitely consider it if he goes huge. That size, pretty happy to just call. Pretty unreasonable size in my opinion, but whatever. I'm actually getting a bit tired. Might have to stop the stream here. Go for a check raise. Oh, yeah, I'll see the next people in.
Visions of a microcosmic vision.
Gonna be going all in it. With all of our chips. Trying to look buffy. Alright. Well, this one kind of got off the ground. 20 cents above $10. This one got to 88.88. Let's pause the music. Get ourselves a little drum roll. Guys, I'm not gonna do it. Actually, I can do it. Let's look at the bankroll. Boom! $92.88. The eights are coming out in their hordes today. Look at that. Look at that. 88. So we're up $92.88. We started on 192. So we just like added 50% to our bankroll. $284.88. I have rounded down a couple of times because I didn't use the exact dollar amount, but I always make sure that I have smaller bankroll than the actual reality is. So, you know,